I often go to a place called Carpenter's Corner on Friday mornings. It's a faith-based lunch program for those needing a meal. While many people are in the kitchen preparing the food, a friend and I connect with those who have shown up for the day. Not always, but often they ask us to pray for specific concerns, which we do with joy and reckless abandon. There are many different ways to focus our prayers. Worshipful prayer gives adoration and reverence to God. Prayers of confession acknowledge our sins against God. Asking for wisdom is a prayer for personal discernment. And when we intervene on behalf of others, we call it intercession. Do you remember when Jesus entered the temple courts and began driving out those who were buying and selling there? He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves, and he said, "Is it not written, 'My house will be called a house of prayer for all nations'?" God's house was a place of intercession for the nations of the world. In Luke 11:5 through 8, Jesus describes persistence in prayer. He says this, "Then he said to them, 'Suppose one of you has a friend, and he goes to him at midnight and says, "Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, because a friend of mine on a journey has come to me, and I have nothing to set before him." Then the one inside answers, "Don't bother me. The door is already locked, and my children are with me in bed. I can't get up and give you anything. I tell you, though he will not get up and give him the bread because he is his friend, yet because of the man's boldness, he will get up and give him as much as he needs." Jesus is stressing a confident boldness that persists in prayer until he gives mercy and grace. Of course, this is not a rude or demanding or disrespectful prayer. We're asking God to answer according to his perfect will and his perfect timing. Someone has said, "If we knew what God knows, we would ask for exactly what he gives." Usually when someone requests prayer at the Carpenter's Corner, it's for healing. Sometimes it's for themselves. At other times, it's for their family or friends. I tell God that I would be thankful for his gracious healing hand, and that it's my desire for them to have their health restored. But I also feel much more confident praying a pastoral prayer. That is, asking the Lord to shepherd their heart in the health concerns, and in Christ to give them a peace that passes all understanding. I do believe that sometimes it's God's will to heal us in this life, but other times he chooses not to heal for now. When we pray for healing, we pray with hopeful expectation, but we cannot and do not demand it as though it were our right. Faith does not always automatically release people from sickness and suffering, but we can be confident that it gives strength to endure until release comes. Often, I'm asking for God's blessing in intercessory prayer. I want God to intersect people's lives in such a good and positive way that they recognize his direct involvement in their lives. Romans 2:4 says that God's kindness is intended to lead to repentance. We often think it's life's difficulties that grabs our attention. And it's true that a crisis does often turn us toward the eternal. But being able to connect the good things that come into our lives with God's favor and blessing is also very meaningful. Sometimes, we need to pray for others struggling in darkness. 1 Peter 5:8 tells us that your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. The enemy allures, he tempts, then entraps on many different levels. It might be consuming pornography, contacting dark spirits, living a lie, following the occult, hating others, or just trying to escape reality. Sin always takes you further than you want to go. It keeps you longer than you want to stay, and it costs you more than you want to pay. For these we take up the full armor of God, and we pray for them in the Spirit with all kinds of prayers and requests. People today desperately need the help that we can give them. Social chaos, psychological confusion, and spiritual deception is profound and rampant. Marriages are being torn apart, and children are being destroyed. Individuals are living lives of quiet desperation with no hope. Our family and friends have struggles and needs, which brings us to our key spiritual insight. We can contribute to the flourishing of others if we will learn to pray on their behalf. For everyone who asks and keeps on asking receives. The person who seeks and keeps on seeking finds. He who knocks and keeps on knocking, the door will be opened.